now we continue discussion about psychotropics, and today's topic is devoted anxiolytics, hypnotics, and neuroleptics. Last lecture, I gave you information about drugs influencing on monoamines. First of all, norepinephrine, dopamine, serotonin. These drugs stimulate the function of these monoamines. Now, we first of all will discuss about drugs influencing on GABA butyric acid, and we discussed about drugs which decrease function of dopamine. You know that GABA butyric acid is a main inhibitory neurotransmitter. You may see on this picture structure of GABA A receptor chloride channel complex and location of by the sites of different central nervous system active drugs. You may see, do you hear me?
Madis, yes, ma'am.
Do you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Well, 1 minute. My dear students, you may see on this picture structure of GABA A receptor. You may see that this receptor consists of five subunits, two alpha subunits, two beta subunits, and one gamma subunits. And all of these subunits in turn are subdivided into some subtypes. For example, alpha subunits include six subtypes, alpha 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and so on, so forth. And different subunits are related to different physiological function. And when we discuss about the different pharmacological function. You for some groups of drugs, for example, for benzodiazepines, for barbiturates, for zolpidem. Zolpidem is drug which is included in group non-benzodiazepines hypnotic. And all of these drugs increase tropism of GABA, GABA, to its receptors. And it, in turn, leads to increased inflow of chloride through chloride ion channel into the cell. And it, in turn, you may see, leads to increased amount of chloride ions in the cell and hyperpolarization. And you know that hyperpolarization is related to decreased propagation of action potential and nerve impulses. On this picture, you may see different functions and conditions related to these different subtypes of subunits. Alpha subunit is related to sleepiness, but alpha 2, 3 subunits are related to emotional states and tone of skeletal muscle. That's why when we use drugs which are more selective, we may reach the desirable pharmacological effect with low side effects. You may see one more synapse, glutamate synapse. You know that glutamate, such as norepinephrine, dopamine, serotonin, is excitatory neurotransmitter. You may see that glutamate has four main receptors, and you have to know that dysfunction in glutamate synapses, first of all, dysfunction in NMDA receptors is related to development a lot of different neurological disease and condition. For example, Alzheimer's disease, depression, epilepsy, and neuron death as well, stroke. I want to stress that a central nervous system contains powerful networks of inhibitory neurons, such GABA neurons, that constantly active and control the rate of neuronal transmission. For example, you may see picture, and you may see glutamate synapse of action potential leads to entering of calcium into the ending of presynaptic neuron. It in turn leads to entering of glutamate into synaptic cleft, binding to own receptors, AMPA and NMDA receptors, and leads to propagation of action potential. But you may see inhibitory GABA synapses, and GABA decrease propagation of action potential, which related to glutamate. Do you understand? My dear students, do you understand?
Yes.
My dear students,
yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
We continue. You may see the classification of psycholeptics. Psycholeptics include neuroleptic or antipsychotic drugs, anxiolytics, and hypnotics and sedatives. First of all, you have to know the main difference between two main condition and disease, between neurosis and psychosis. Neurosis, it is diseases which are related to function problem in the central nervous system, only functional problem. And when there is neurosis, the person always stays within the reality. But psychosis, unfortunately, is related to organic disturbances in the brain. In most cases, psychosis related to some gene disturbances. And when there is psychosis, the person has no control over their thoughts and emotions. You know that anxiety states, neurosis, and sleep disturbances, such as insomnia, are common problem. And now, when there is coronavirus, a lot of people, most people, has stress, and stress directly psychosis. And I told for you about adaptogens. I told for you about last lecture about psycholeptics. And this group adaptogens, and adaptogens is very useful group which may prevent stress and which may, not may, can diminish consequences of stress. That's why I recommend for your parents, for your friends, use now drugs from this group, adaptogens. We continue, and fortunately, psychosis, disease, which are led to psychosis, appear very rarely in our life, in our world. It's good. Anxiety, which characterized by excessive feeling of worry, fear, nervousness, and severe anxiety. Physical symptoms of severe anxiety are similar to those of fear, such as tachycardia, dry mouth, sweating, tremor, and so on and so forth. I want to stress that episodes of mild anxiety are common life experiences and don't require treatment. But when there is severe chronic anxiety, patient добрый день. Лекцию могу коротко. Так.
Так, сейчас запишу, подождите. По той неделе, какого числа? 2 декабря, 8 часов, курсовые работы, которые предыдущих лет. Хорошо, 19 года. Хорошо, я поняла. Предыдущие курсовые. Угу. Хорошо, все, договорились. Спасибо, спасибо.
Да. Нет, ищ. Я говорила не про них дополнительно, я говорила про тех, кого мы сейчас отправили на дистант, про наших. Да. Угу. Ну, недопущены, недопущены. Чтобы их отчисляли. Угу. Хорошо, хорошо, я поняла. Спасибо. Спасибо. Sorry, my dear students, with chronic anxiety patient, can't overcome these disturbances in its condition, and the patient needs to seek professional help. When in addition to nervousness, impaired concentration, irritability, there are symptoms related to activation of sympathetic nervous system. When there is combination both of nervousness, impaired concentration, irritability, and symptoms of overactivation of sympathetic nervous system, this patient needs to seek professional help. There are classification of anxiety disorder. You may see classification on this slide, but during this educational year, we don't discuss about each of these anxiety disorders. We discuss in general about groups which we may use. More exactly, more fully, you have to, will observe this group during a psychiatry course. For example, phobia anxiety. What is phobia anxiety? Phobia means the fear, but it is not just fear. It necessary that the fear must be stable, constant, and irrational, not based on sound judgment. For example, I'm afraid snake. I live in Penza. In Penza, a very low number of snake, but I'm very afraid snake in my flat, maybe. It is phobia anxiety. When there is fear which is not based on sound judgment. You may see symptoms of anxiety disorder. You understand that all the symptoms is related to overactivation of sympathetic nervous system. And the doctor may put diagnosis of anxiety when in a threatening situations there is at least two of these following symptoms. And one of them must be included in four first, such as tachycardia, sweating, tremor of trembling or dry mouth. I repeat one more time. There are two symptoms, and one of them must be included in four first symptoms. Do you understand? My dear students, do you understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
We continue.
Yes.
And insomnia. What is insomnia or sleep disorder? Insomnia is inability to initiate or maintain or achieve the restful sleep. Hypnotic drugs produce drowsiness and encourage the onset of sleep and allow to maintain of state of sleep. Hypnotic effect involve more pronounced depression of the central nervous system than sedation, and this can be achieved with many drugs sedatives when they administer in increased doses. You may see some brain symptoms such as limbic system, thalamus and hypothalamus. And anxiolytic effect is related to inhibition of these subcortical regions and violation of their connection with the bark. You may see when there is increased function of GABA, it leads to anxiolytic action. You may see one example. You see photo in which there are very aggressive rats. Rats are located in special cage, and electric current flows the bottom of this cage, and it lead to development of pain in rats, and rats are very aggressive. Next photo, the same box, the same rats, the same current, but you may see lack of fight under the influence of anxiolytics. One more picture about action mechanisms of anxiolytics. Anxiolytics increased function of GABA, increased tropism of GABA to its receptors, and it leads to increased inflow of chloride ions into cells. It in turn results in hyperpolarization and diminished propagation of action potential. On this picture, you may see drugs which have receptors in GABA receptor complex. Drugs such as benzodiazepines, barbiturates, and non-benzodiazepines, hypnotics, or the other name for this group is Z-hypnotics. First of all, we discuss about benzodiazepine. The important clinical classification of benzodiazepines is subdivided this group into three subgroups by duration of action. Long acting, moderate acting, and short acting drugs. It's very important for us because you know duration of action of drugs, and when patient has disturbances in onset of sleep, you may administer drugs which have short duration of action. We continue anxiolytic classification. The next group of anxiolytics is azapirones and buspirone. And this group include buspirone and other derivatives of buspirone. Next group includes some drugs with a different action mechanism, such as hydroxyzine, meprobamat. These drugs are rarely used in clinical practice. And there is one more group, beta blockers. Beta blockers aren't anxiolytics. I want to stress it. Beta blockers aren't anxiolytics, but beta blockers reduce symptoms of anxiety by blockade beta adrenal receptors. That's why we may use this group when there is anxiety disorder in order to reduce symptoms of overactivation of sympathetic nervous system. One more time, you may see GABA receptor complex and action of benzodiazepines. First picture, a GABA receptor without GABA and benzodiazepines. The second picture, GABA binds to its receptors, and you may see inflow of chlorine ions. And the third picture, you may see GABA, which binds to its receptors, and benzodiazepines as well, which binds to its receptors, and you may see increased inflow of calcium ions into the cell and increased action of the GABA. That's why I repeat on one more time, benzodiazepines increase action of inhibitory neurotransmitter GABA aminobutyric acid. You may see differentiation between function of some subunits, alpha subunits. Alpha subunit is related to sedation and sleepness, but alpha 2 and alpha 3 subunits are related to anxiolytic and mass relaxing actions. Benzodiazepines stimulate all alpha subunits, but other hypnotics, such as non-benzodiazepine hypnotics, such as zolpidem, zaleplon, bind only to alpha subunit. That's why these drugs may cause low amount of pharmacological effects and low amount side effects as well. And when we have treat only insomnia, we prefer this group of drugs in order to prevent some side effects related to stimulation of alpha 2 and alpha 3 subunits. You may see two picture. First picture, there is anxiety related to fear, but the second picture, there isn't fear under anxiolytic. Sorry, my students, 1 minute. Vladimir, да, могу коротко, как вы? Тогда делаем так. Вы сегодня покупаете реферон и прям сегодня его используете. Вы сейчас покупаете и используете. Да, увеличим долю. Вечером созваниваемся. Значит, вы все продолжаете как и раньше, только добавляете реферон 1 миллион. По миллиону один раз в день. Если вы не найдете свечи по миллиону, можно использовать по 500 тысяч два раза в день. Да, мы договорились. Да, до вечера. До свидания. We continue, my dear students, we continue. About pharmacological effects of benzodiazepines. Benzodiazepines cause anxiolytic action by reduction of anxiety. These drugs cause anticonvulsant action, muscle relaxant action, sedation and hypnotic action. You may see that different pharmacological effects are related to different alpha subunits. Reduction of anxiety, anticonvulsant and muscle relaxant actions related to alpha 2 subunits, but sedation and hypnotic actions are related to alpha 1 subunits. Unfortunately, benzodiazepines may cause a lot of side effects. First of all, psychical and physical dependence. That's why we use this drug with cautiously during short-term period, 2, maybe 4 weeks, not more. Next, groziness and confusion, cognitive impairment, ataxia, and ataxia in turn is related to increased risk of fracture. Why is it so? Why there is decreased function of there is decreased physical and psychical performance? You may see this in picture. You may see ideal hypnotic and ideal anxiolytic. Unfortunately, benzodiazepines binding to alpha receptors, increased function of GABA, and it's related to these side effects. Cognitive impairment and physical impairment as well, such as ataxia. Abrupt discontinuation of the benzodiazepines result in withdrawal symptoms, such as deterioration of anxiety. That's why we have to discontinue taking of these drugs gradually, step by step. Next, in patient who have respiratory depression, pulmonary disease, these drugs in therapeutic dosage, I have to stress it, in therapeutic dosage may cause respiratory depression by influencing on respiratory center in the brain. And in patients who have cardiovascular disease, these drugs, I stress, in therapeutic dosage may cause cardiovascular depression by influencing on cardiovascular vasomotor center in the central nervous system. That's why doctor has to use this group with cautiously, especially in elderly patient. Doctor has to use this drug during short-term period, 2, maybe 4 weeks, not more. When we say about treatment of anxiety disorder, you know that we may use two groups of drugs. First group is benzodiazepines. The second group is antidepressants, such as selective drugs and norepinephrine selective drugs. I review for you this drug decrease reuptaking of excitatory neurotransmitters such as serotonin and norepinephrine back into presynaptic neuron. And that's why lead to increased function of these excitatory neurotransmitters. But you have to know that benzodiazepines have a rapid onset of action. And in acute anxiety states, we prefer use especially this group. But when there is a chronic condition, we may use other group as well. You may see chronic treatment of anxiety disorder, and you may see in this list benzodiazepines and drugs which we use when there is depression, antidepressants. But when there is acute anxiety states, we use only benzodiazepines, because benzodiazepines have a rapid onset of action. Next group, next indication for anxiolytics, sleep disorders. I repeat one more time, we must use this drugs during short-term period, 2 for 4 weeks. And when there is disturbances in onset of sleepness, of sleep, they prefer drugs with short duration of action because these drugs has low side effects compared to drugs which have prolonged duration of action. For example, we may use midazolam and triazolam. I want to come back. I want to tell you about azapirones and about buspirone. Buspirone, compared to benzodiazepines, has low amount of side effects. This drug may cause headache, dizziness, and dyspepsia. But this drug has one negative feature. The onset, this drug has delayed onset of action. All other anxiolytics have rapid onset of action, and only one buspirone and their derivatives have delayed onset of action. That's why we can't use this drug when there is acute anxiety disorder. We continue, and next therapeutic uses for anxiolytic muscular disorder and seizures. You know that these drugs cause a relaxation of skeletal muscles. That's why we may use this drug when there is muscle spasm, muscle strain, and in conditions when there are some spasticity. For example, multiple sclerosis, cerebral palsy, and we use these drugs when there are seizures in order to remove seizures by relaxation skeletal muscles. When we say about muscle relaxants, we have to know that there are central acting drugs and peripheral acting drugs. Peripheral acting drugs include neuromuscular blockers, about which we discussed some weeks ago during practical classes. Next, peripheral acting drugs include as well dantrolene and botulinum toxin. Now we say about central acting muscle relaxants, such as benzodiazepine and baclofen. Now we discuss about benzodiazepines, but I want to explain you that there are other drugs which may relax skeletal muscles by influencing on central nervous system. They are baclofen, tizanidine, and gabapentin. I repeat one more time. There are two groups: peripherally acting muscle relaxant, botulinum toxin, and there are centrally acting drugs such as benzodiazepines, gabapentin, tizanidine, baclofen. Buspirone, we must not use as muscle relaxant because buspirone doesn't have this pharmacological effect. We discussed about benzodiazepines, about their action mechanism, and very shortly I observe baclofen, tizanidine, and gabapentin. On this picture, you may see inhibitory interneuron, and you may see that inhibitory interneuron, which inhibit in turn motor neuron, and motor neuron controls tone of muscles, skeletal muscles. Inhibitory interneuron has some receptors. First of all, for GABA-A, and we discussed about benzodiazepines, for GABA-B, and for alpha 2 adrenal receptors. You may see that baclofen binds to GABA-B adrenal receptors on postsynaptic membranes, leads to decreased propagation of excitatory impulse to muscle. Baclofen binds to GABA-B receptors on presynaptic membranes as well. And it in turn leads to decreased releasing of glutamate, such as excitatory neurotransmitter, and there is decreased stimulation of glutamate its receptors. And it in turn leads to decreased propagation of excitatory nervous impulses. Next, tizanidine. Tizanidine stimulates presynaptic alpha 2 adrenal receptors, which in turn leads to decreased release of glutamate into synaptic cleft and decreased propagation of excitatory action potential. And there is one more drug, gabapentin. Gabapentin has a complex action mechanism, and the main part in this action mechanism is related to increased production of GABA. And GABA in turn leads to decreased propagation of action potential. Do you understand, my dear students? My dear students, do you understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, doctor. Yes, ma'am.
Mm-hmm. We continue. We continue about dantrolene. It's very interesting drug. Only dantrolene may save life of patient who has a condition known as malignant hyperthermia, very high temperature, malignant hyperthermia. This severe condition is related to some gene disturbances in using some drugs such as centrally acting anesthetics and neuroleptics, about which now we will discuss. Only dantrolene may save life in patients with malignant hyperthermia. The action mechanism of dantrolene is related to decreased releasing of calcium from sarcoplasmatic reticulum. That's why decreased level of calcium in the cells associated with relaxation of muscles, and especially contraction of skeletal muscles is related to development of malignant hyperthermia. Very strong, muscle constriction. And one more drug, Botox. Botox entering, entering through, no, Botox passes through presynaptic membrane into fiber ending and binds to acetylcholine. And acetylcholine can't release to synaptic cleft and stimulate acetylcholine receptors. That's why it results in muscle relaxation. Next indication for benzodiazepines, premedication. We use short-acting agents as premedication drugs for anxiety provoking and unpleasant procedures, such as endoscopic, bronchoscopic, dental procedures, as well as angioplasty. We use this drug in order to cause sedation. Next, withdrawal syndrome. When a patient has drug abuse or alcohol abuse and is treated by special drugs, we may add for combination for treatment of this patient benzodiazepines. There are some contraindications for administration of benzodiazepines. There are some restrictions, and you have to know that when there is acute narrow angle glaucoma, doctor should be avoid administration in patient this group. You have to know that alcohol and other psycholeptics increase action of benzodiazepines and other psycholeptics. Each psycholeptic increases action of other psycholeptic. When there is a toxicity related to using of benzodiazepines, unfortunately, people may use this group in order to die, suicidal attempt. Or maybe patient use high dosage by chance. There is benzodiazepine antagonist which may remove benzodiazepines in binding to its receptors and save life of patient. Buspirone. I told about this drug, one more time I repeat, has slow onset of action. It negative features, it's negative features of drugs. That's why we can't use this drug when there is acute condition. Side effect, headache, dizziness, and dyspepsia. Hydroxyzine, we use such anti-emetic drug. And all therapeutic uses for anxiolytics, for relief of anxiety, for insomnia, treatment of epilepsy and seizure states, for muscle relaxation in specific neuromuscular disorders, for sedation and amnesia before surgical and medical procedures, for control of sonoma, phase sedative, hypnotic withdrawal states, for treatment of psychiatry. I want to stress buspirone we may use only for relief of anxiety, because buspirone has delayed onset of action. Hypnotics. There are three main groups of hypnotics, benzodiazepines. We observed this group. Next group is non-benzodiazepines, which we known as Z-hypnotics as well, and others, tanolamines, derivatives of aliphatic and melatonin drugs. Z-hypnotics bind only subtypes alpha 1 subunit. That's but I repeat one more time, selectiveness is a relative feature of drugs. Selectiveness is a relative feature of drugs. And when we increase dosage of drug selectiveness is decreased. That's why in general, pharmacology of Z-hypnotics is similar to that of benzodiazepines. But this drug may cause this drug may treat insomnia predominantly. Other pharmacological effects, such as relaxation of skeletal muscle, removing of seizures, these drugs can't cause. We administer this group only when there is insomnia in order to initiate the onset of sleep, in order to maintain the sleep. But the side effects of this group are similar to those of benzodiazepines, but there is one difference. These side effects may appear very rarely, and these side effects are less pronounced compared to benzodiazepines. Do you understand, my dear students?
Yes, ma'am. Mm-hmm. Yes, ma'am.
And
yes, ma'am.
Compare in contrast to benzodiazepines, these drugs can be divided into three groups by duration of action. Zaleplon has duration of action only 2-3 hours, and when there is disturbances in onset of sleep, we prefer especially this drug. Zolpidem has duration of action of 5 hours, and Zopiclone 6-8 hours. Antihistamines. These drugs bind to H1 histaminic receptors and muscarinic receptors as well. That's why these drugs have side effects related to influencing on these receptors, such as atropine-like side effects and increased appetite and weight gain related to influencing on H1 histamine receptors. That's why we use this group very rarely compared to benzodiazepine, compared to Z-hypnotics. Chloride hydrides we use very rarely. And a very interesting group, melatonin and drugs and derivatives of melatonin. You know this hormone from course of physiology. It's very important hormone for us. You know that there is a low level of melatonin during night. It's related to formation, development of a lot of diseases, such as cardiovascular diseases, and increased risk of cancer diseases as well. That's why it's very important to have high level of melatonin during night. У меня лекция, перезвоню. You may see drug Ramelton. Ramelton stimulate melatonin receptors. And this drug doctors use in patients with insomnia in which falling asleep and in which falling asleep is the primary complications. Side effects of Ramelton include dizziness, fatigue, somnolence, increased prolactin levels. Ramelton is contraindicated when there is diabetes, first of all, autoimmune disease, pregnancy, and lactation. Unfortunately, in some countries, for example, in United States, a lot of people take melatonin in big dosage. It isn't right way because it is hormone and we started to use this drug only some years ago. We don't know the delayed complications of these drugs when we use big dosage because it is hormone. That's why only doctors have administered most of drugs and melatonin as well. Next group, which we discuss now, neuroleptics. Neuroleptics is each group which may remove psychosis. It's very important group when there is psychosis. The main disease related to psychosis is schizophrenia. Schizophrenia, fortunately, takes place in only 1% of the population. And it's disabling disorder, unfortunately. And schizophrenia is related to some gene disturbances. We must not treat this disease. We may only decrease number of relapse of this condition. Patients with psychosis, patients with psychosis have delusions, hallucinations, and catatonic behavior or diminished emotional expression. Three main features: delusions, signs and symptoms, delusions, hallucination, such agitation or diminished emotional expression. Hallucination, you may see. What is hallucinations? Hallucinations are things that are sent but not real. The delusions are beliefs that aren't real or correct. And you may see on this picture catatonia or catatonic syndrome. Catatonic syndrome appear by one of both, psychomotor agitation or stupor. Patient may be very aggressive, or may be in stupor condition. Catatonic agitation, catatonic stupor, you may see on these pictures. And these symptoms, catatonic behavior, may take place during a lot of hours and days as well without the treatment. Schizophrenia is not only cause of psychosis. There are other diseases and conditions which may lead to developosis. For example, other types of psychiatric illnesses, for example, bipolar disorder, substance abuse, non-psychiatric neurological conditions such as brain tumor, stroke, central nervous system infections, endocrine disorders such as Cushing's disease, hyperthyroidism, vitamin B12 deficiency, and neurodegenerative disorder. But the main cause of psychosis is schizophrenia. Symptoms of schizophrenia can be divided into three types. The first positive included hallucinations, delusions, and catatonic behavior. Negative symptoms included loss of motivation and social withdrawal. And the third part included cognitive symptoms, impairment of working memory, attention deficit, inability to initiate, regulate playing activities. Criteria for diagnosis, да. There are four main dopamine pathways which related to main signs and symptoms of schizophrenia and main side effects related to administration of neuroleptics. You may see mesolimbic way, which related to development of positive symptoms such as hallucinations, delusions, and catatonia. Mesocortical way is related to development of negative symptoms and cognitive impairment as well. Nigrostriatal way is related to the main group of side effects associated with extrapyramidal impairment and tuberohypophyseal way is related to increased production of prolactin and conditions associated with increased level of prolactin. There are two groups of neuroleptics. First generation we know as typicals, and second generation we know as atypicals. Between these two generations, there is one big difference. Typicals cause extrapyramidal side effects very widely, very frequently. but atypicals may cause extrapyramidal side effects very rarely, and it's fortunately, it's great. Classification of neuroleptics, I repeat one more time, includes typical drugs and atypical, and both of groups are in turn related into three subgroups. Typical agents include derivatives of phenothiazine, derivatives of teoxanthen, and derivatives of butyrophenol. You may see that these drugs reduce positive symptoms of psychosis. Unfortunately, negative symptoms, impairment, cognitive impairment is not aren't removed under typical drugs. Unfortunately, these drugs cause a lot of extrapyramidal side effects and increased production of prolactin. The second generation atypical drugs include derivatives of benzodiazepine, derivatives of benzamide, and derivatives of indole. In most cases, we use derivatives of clozapine. You may see clozapine first subgroups. In first subgroups is included, and especially these group of clozapine, doctors prefer in patients with psychosis in order to prevent psychosis or remove psychosis. Atypical drugs block both of dopamine receptors and serotonin receptors. That's why this group cause other side effects compared to first generation and has other pharmacological effects. I want to repeat for you, maybe I don't know about this, I ask that one more time. The main action mechanism of neuroleptics is blockade of dopaminic receptor. The main action mechanism, blockade of dopamine receptor. And both of generation, first generation and second generation, blockade, you may see, dopamine receptor. And blockade of dopamine receptor is related to both of pharmacological effect, positive pharmacological effects, and side effects as well. Most of neuroleptics block not only dopamine receptors, but muscarinic receptors, alpha-adrenergic receptors, and H1 histamine receptors. Blockade of these types of receptors are related to side effects of neuroleptics.
Виктор Львович, добрый день.
Sorry, one minute.
Как вы себя чувствуете? Вы не заболели? Виктор Львович, вы заболели, вы что делаете? Виктор Львович, вы сами меня говорите, что нет температуры для заболевания. Виктор Львович, ну вы зря, Виктор Львович. Угу. Преподаватель сами свяжутся со студентами или как? Давайте мы сейчас, вы на скидку не помните номера групп, которые сейчас будут распространяться? А, ладно, сейчас мы скажем, сегодня будет работать. Сейчас мы разместим. Хорошо, договорились, короче. Ага. Хорошо. Петрович, да, но я вам сейчас хотела как раз звонить вашему начмеду. Я так и не дошла до вас, но не могу сюда вырваться по своим делам. Петрович, а поэтому ты сами говоришь, что что-нибудь там что-то крутится. Вы до скольки будете? До 12. Петрович, я вот прямо сейчас лекцию дочитываю, мне еще 15-20 минут, а вам приеду. Угу. Спасибо.
My dear students, we continue. And you may see one more time, blockade of some receptors and side effects related to these blockades. Так. About pharmacological effects of neuroleptics. The main effect is antipsychotic action.